material or instruction material beyond what has been supplied to you already, that is volumetric experiments, chemistry laboratory manual.
Sir,
yes
sir, YouTube से मतलब जो दिक्कत होता है YouTube से पढ़ लेते हैं.
सॉरी बताओ फिर से बोलो.
जो दिक्कत होता है कुछ भी तो YouTube से पढ़ लेते.
क्या होता है?
अगर दिक्कत होती है तो YouTube से पढ़ लेते हैं.
नहीं, यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल प्रॉपरली. आई कांट हियर यू प्रॉपरली. Your volume, increase your volume.
Hello.
Yes, now I am, you are audible. Yes.
Sir, अगर दिक्कत होता है तो YouTube से देख लेते हैं.
Yes. Yes. That's what I have advised you to. There are plenty of good ones, good YouTube videos. And you should consult them. You should learn from those videos. If our videos are not very properly prepared in a hurry, but professionally filmed videos are really, really nice videos. So I will give you link also if I will find a particular experiment in YouTube. I can share it with you. Thank you. I hope 4 experiments you have. Since more emphasis is on during offline classes, the volumetric exercises matter more, but here every it doesn't matter. Equal weightage, equal importance should be given to volumetric as well as non-volumetric exercises. Have I shared the non-volumetric exercise, instruction manual experiments with you or not? Teaching material. Riya? Riya Prajapati.
Yes, sir. No, you haven't shared it.
Tell me, have I shared
the
non-volumetric exercises laboratory manual with you or not?
No, sir. You haven't shared that. No, sir.
Not yet. So, yes, okay, it will be shared. All the experiments in advance. All next four or five experiments are there. You can guess which is coming next. Today's exercise is Abel's, determination of the flash point of a of an oil by using flash point, Abel's for flash point apparatus. Very simple, straightforward.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, hello.
So can you start the recording?
Start
the recording.
Recording is already there. I'm recording it.
Okay, sorry, sir. Okay.
Yes. Oh, sorry. Yes, it is already being recorded. Okay. So now I'm going to share straight away today's experiment. I'm going to explain to you, and then rest. You know what you are supposed to do. So. Is it okay? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Determination of flash point. अगर आपने ये पढ़ा है flash point के बारे में तो अच्छी बात है. अगर नहीं पढ़ा है तो fuels से related है ये topic. तो fuels अब इस week में it will start. In theory, it is very I mean, simple flash point, the minimum temperature gives a flash. I mean, on heating, it if it produces sufficient vapors, which can be ignited on ignition, gives a flash, burns with a flash. That is flash point. And flash point is, since it is related with the inflammability of liquid oil, it is of practical use in storage of the oil and transportation, etc. So two methods it is a closed flash point apparatus, Ebel's, and method. There are two methods. A is for oil flashing below 32, and method B is for oils which flash between 32 and 49 degrees Celsius. In method A, the heating vessel is filled to overflowing with warm water, and its temperature is adjusted to 55 degrees Celsius at the beginning of the test. The test flame is adjusted to a bead approximately 4 mm in diameter and compared with the projecting white bead mounted on the cover to maintain its size constant. The temperature of the sample is adjusted to approximately 15 degrees Celsius and filled in the already washed and dried oil cup until the liquid just reaches the level mark. Outside water is there, inside, two chambers are separated, and inside you fill the testing oil. The oil cup is fitted with the cover with a slight close and placed in the heating vessel. The thermometers are so inserted that if cup is properly placed, the thermometer's scale faces the operator. You should be able to see the temperature, observe the temperature in thermometers used in this experiment. The test flame is set up, and when the temperature of oil reaches 20 degrees Celsius, test flame is applied. By slowly opening the slit after every 0.5 degree Celsius rise in temperature and close immediately until a distinct flash occurs in the interior of the cup, this temperature is recorded as flash point. The vessel is not heated during the test. So, pehle hi se heat kar lete hain vessel ko sufficient temperature jo bahar hota hai. The method B is in this method it is same as described above, except that in this case the air chamber is filled to a depth of 4 cm with cold water, and the heating vessel is filled with cold water. The vessel is heated at a rate which gives a temperature rise of 1 degree Celsius per minute. The testing in this case is started when the temperature has risen to 25 degree Celsius. This procedure, I think there it is not very convincing literature which has been probably provided in your instruction manual. But what it is, it is just what instruction manual tells you. So I am stopping this, and I would try to show you a video by which you can understand better. Stop. Just a moment, let me share again. Yes, you can. This is the Abel's flashpoint apparatus. Here you are filling the water. Outer jacket. This is a stirrer. The stirring is being done for homogenizing the liquid, the temperature as such. And thermostat heating is done at constant temperature, controlling the temperature with thermostat outside, and after some time, see what happens. No, it is. I'm not convinced with this. I think this video has been hello. I think this video has been prepared in a hurry. So I'm not convinced with this video. Myself, I'm not happy. So wait for till we find a good YouTube video on Abel's method. That's it for today, and I will upload the instruction manual for non-volumetric exercises of coming weeks. So flashpoint by Abel's, flashpoint by Penske Martin, and some other experiments, aniline point, etc. So these are mostly, these are related with fuels and oils. That's it. Any questions? I am now going to record the attendance, today's attendance.
So when will you share the video?
Sorry?